We want to simplify the given complex fraction. And while there are a couple of ways to simplify complex fractions, I think to keep it consistent, it's best to first find the difference on the top, find the sum on the bottom, and then since the fraction bar represents division, we can write the complex fraction as a division problem involving two rational expressions. So again, looking at the top, in order to subtract these two fractions, we must obtain a common denominator. Let's first put all the denominators in parentheses. Now again, looking at the top, notice how the least common denominator would be the product of the two denominators, or the quantity x minus 2 times the quantity x plus 2, which means this first fraction must have a factor of x plus 2 in the denominator. So we're going to multiply both the top and bottom by the quantity x plus 2. Notice the second fraction needs a factor of x minus 2, which means we'll multiply the second fraction by x minus 2 over x minus 2. Now looking at the bottom, notice how the common denominator is still going to be the same. It's going to be the quantity x minus 2 times the quantity x plus 2. So again, this first fraction is missing a factor of x plus 2. So we'll multiply by x plus 2 over x plus 2. And the second fraction is missing a factor of x minus 2. So we'll multiply by x minus 2 over x minus 2. So now that we have common denominators, we can find this difference on top and this sum on the bottom. Again, notice the common denominator on top is the quantity x minus 2 times the quantity x plus 2. And now we can combine the numerators, which would be 4 times the quantity x plus 2 minus 1 times the quantity x minus 2. And we'll simplify this numerator in the next step. Now looking at the bottom, again our common denominator is x minus 2 times x plus 2. And now we can combine the numerators. The first numerator would be x times the quantity x plus 2, and then plus 1 times the quantity x minus 2. So again, now we're going to simplify the numerator here and the numerator here. So to simplify the numerators, we first want to clear the parentheses. So here we'll distribute 4, and because of the minus here, we'll think of distributing negative 1. So we would have 4x plus 8, and then minus 1x, and then negative 1 times negative 2 would be positive 2, so we have minus x plus 2. Now looking at the bottom, we would distribute x here, and we can think of distributing 1 here, which wouldn't change anything. So we'd have x squared plus 2x, and then plus x minus 2. And now we'll combine like terms in the numerators here and here. So 4x minus 1x would be 3x, and 8 plus 2 would be 10. Now down at the bottom, we have x squared, and then 2x plus 1x is 3x, so plus 3x, and then minus 2. Now because we have one rational expression on top and one rational expression on the bottom, and a fraction bar represents division, we can write this as a division problem. We'd have the fraction on top divided by the fraction on the bottom. Normally we don't divide by fractions, we multiply by the reciprocal. So we can write the division as a multiplication problem. So again, the first fraction will stay the same. But instead of dividing by the second fraction, we're going to multiply by the reciprocal, which would be the quantity x minus 2 times the quantity x plus 2 over the quantity x squared plus 3x minus 2. Now before we find this product, we want to simplify by making sure everything is factored and then simplify out the common factors between the numerators and denominators. And 3x plus 10 doesn't factor, and neither does x squared plus 3x minus 2. Notice there are no factors of negative 2 that add to positive 3. But we can simplify x minus 2 over x minus 2. That simplifies to 1, and so does x plus 2 over x plus 2. So the simplified form of the complex fraction would be the quantity 3x plus 10 over the quantity x squared plus 3x minus 2. Now if we had to enter this answer online, we would have to have a set of parentheses around the numerator and around the denominator. We would have to enter open parenthesis 3x plus 10, close parenthesis, divided by open parenthesis x squared plus 3x minus 2, close parenthesis. This would be the simplified form of the complex fraction. I hope you found this helpful.